Hello, this is a video on how to calibrate an ORP electrode, a Memosens ORP electrode, and we'll be using a 907 multi-portable analyzer for the calibration. The electrode that we're going to use is actually an SE554 AMSN combination electrode, which is pH and ORP. As I already said, it is a Memosens. And as you can see here, we have the cable plugged into the top, and then we have the other end of the cable right here, which connects onto the electrode, the SE554 combination. So when you make that connection, you get serial number, you get the last calibration, manufacturer, all that good information. So I'm going to remove the wetting cap that's on there. And because this is a combo probe, as I said, it does ORP and pH at the same time. I'm going to put it into the buffer here, or the calibration solution, I should say. So now, anytime you do a calibration on this type of electrode, a pH or ORP electrode, a couple of things you want to keep in mind. One, you want to make sure they're clean. Any debris, any kind of mineral deposits, anything that could coat the glass portion or the ORP portion or plugging the junction could and will affect the calibration, the quality of the calibration. So again, you want to start off with a clean electrode, and we have other videos that you can watch on how to prepare and clean an electrode for calibration. So as I said, this is a combo probe. So right now you'll notice this is pH that it's reading, but if I hit measure, I can see the millivolt value or ORP value coming out of the ORP portion. So we'll go ahead and do a calibration on both sides of it, but the ORP is what we're primarily after. Now, whenever you calibrate an ORP, you want to use a known standard so that you can get a proper calibration. In this case, we're using a 220 millivolt ORP standard at 25 degrees Celsius. Now I'm going to apologize because the glare is going to get in the way, but if you come to 25 degrees C, skip through this column just for a moment, come across to 220 millivolts at a pH of 7. And that's for silver chloride reference systems, which is exactly what we have here. This other column I mentioned right here is for a different type of reference system that we do not have within the Kinnick product line. So good standard to use, 220 millivolts at 25 degrees Celsius. Now to do the calibration, and by the way, if I didn't mention it, this is also a buffer 7 as well as a 220 millivolt standard. So we can also do the calibration. I think I did mention it, or check it at least, because it is a buffer 7. So let's go ahead and hit menu, calibration. Now here we select how do we want to calibrate. So right now we're going to do ORP. Okay. So I hit enter, I hit start. So now I'm going to tell it at 23 degrees Celsius. Actually, we're between 20 and 25, so I'm going to tell it that it is 220 millivolts, which we already have. But if I wanted to change it, I could do that. So I hit enter. Okay, my correction value is going to be negative 18 millivolts based on the reading. I hit apply. There we go. So we're at 220 millivolts. And we have our smiley, which is indicating that the calibration is good and there's nothing wrong with the electrode, nothing that would cause us any kind of a problem. So now I'm going to hit menu, calibration. I'm going to hit manual. I'm going to do 2-point calibration. Now I'm going to calibrate the pH side. So again, 23.1, I'm currently reading 6.97, which is pretty close. I hit start. If I were in a buffer 4 at this moment, I could come over and change it, but of course I'm not. I'm in a buffer 7. I hit enter. Continue. While that's doing that, I'm going to open up the buffer 4 so I can do my second point of calibration. Okay, so it's telling me go ahead and enter a dip sensor into the second buffer. So here, I'm going to go ahead and enter a buffer 4, and I'm going to remove this from the buffer 7. I'm going to wash it. So what you can't see is I'm using some DI water to wash off the electrode. I'm going to remove my buffer 7. I'm going to go ahead and dip the electrode into a buffer 4. Stir it just a little bit. Now, right now I'm going to let it stabilize. So I want to make sure that my pH value is stable. And I also want to make sure my temperature is stable. And patience is important here. So you want to make sure that it's not moving in value more than once per second. So pH value looks pretty stable. Temperature, I would say we're also stable. So I'm going to go ahead and hit enter here so it gets me ready to continue. So I hit continue, and it's going to start the calibration for the second buffer, which is a buffer 4. So again, we've already calibrated the ORP. Here we go. Here's the results of my pH 2-point manual calibration. So I've got a response time of 15 seconds, a slope of 96.9, a 0.7.2 at 13.1 millivolts. It's showing me my two buffer values, 4 and 7, and it's giving me the smiley. So of course, if I don't hit apply, that calibration will not be put into the electrode or the adjustment won't take place. So remember, you have to hit apply. There we go. And there's our pH value, 4. I'm going to go ahead and move it over to the 7. You can see it coming up. And we'll take a look at the ORP value, which is 219. And by the way, what you don't see is that we're in the same ORP solution we started with, which is 220 millivolts, and also a buffer of 7, 6.96. I'd say we're in good shape. All right, that's it for this video. Hope this was informative. Thank you. Bye.